over me. Run through the land, you run through my soul. Bring me wisdom and peace. Run through all ages and all of life's stages. You bring me around to find my release.
Hi, this is Jan Lewis, and what a pleasure today to have back with us two of my favorite guests. Many of you may have heard them on WCRN Radio. You've certainly seen them here on Be My Guest. Alex and Peter Lee, welcome, guys. Welcome back. They are, I'm going to get this straight, because Alex, the Professional Hearing Care Associates, and they own Pro Hearing Health over in Westboro. And if you know where Tatnuck Bookseller is, they're right near there. So it's easy to get to them. Here they are. A great sign. Before we go any further, exactly when you pass Tatnuck, how do you get there?
So if you pass Tatnuck and it's on your left, our building is, you go down the street a few hundred feet and it'll be on the right.
Take a right, come in the front door, mm-hmm. right? And you can't miss it, you got a sign. Get a sign, and Alex was showing me that a friend of his had done a wonderful video, actually showing how you go into the mm-hmm. office and is showing you all around. I think that's fantastic. Going back, when did you start the company? Which one of you started it?
I started it back in 1993. So I say over 25 years because I don't want to do the math, but if you did the math, it's even more.
Where did you start it, Pete?
Right in Westboro.
Right in Westboro? At your home?
Was it in your home? No. We actually were in Route 9 in the same complex where they used to have Doc in the Box, Dr. Jane, J-A-I-N.
Oh, okay. And, so you were there?
We were there for a couple of years, and then it was a good location, except it was right on Route 9. Yeah. And the problem with being on 9 for the elderly population, the senior population, was if they miss the turn, yeah. we won't see them until the next day or sometimes even the next week.
Oh,
so missed the appointment, and they'll say, we call them and say, oh, you had an appointment at 9:30.
We couldn't find you.
Oh, yeah, I went by there, but I missed the turn, but, you know, I'm back home now, and I'll try again tomorrow or the next week, but they can only do one thing.
Well, that was 25 years ago. Now, when did you move to your one that's
95. Okay. 95, we moved to our current location.
And when did you join your dad?
I joined about 6 years ago now.
Yeah.
And it's been great working with him, working together, helping people hear better. It's a lot of fun.
Alex has had his own. Briefly, tell us again about your own experience with hearing.
Yeah, so I was in the first grade when I was diagnosed with a hearing problem. And it's really cool because my dad had already, you know, been in the industry. And I would go see my dad and he would take care of my ears. He would, you know, look inside my ears, clean my ears, test and evaluate my hearing. And then he would fit and program, troubleshoot my hearing aids. So everything that I learned about how to service patients is what I learned from him. So,
Dad, where did you go to school to learn this?
So I have an undergraduate degree from Tufts University. Yeah. It's in engineering. And I have worked in engineering for about 8-10 years. And then I decided to break out on my own. And then that's when I worked with a national retailer. For hearing aids, I learned the practice, and then I started out my own a couple of years later.
Now, if somebody either needs hearing aids or they need their hearing aid adjusted, they come right to Pro Hearing Health, right?
Mm-hmm. Yes. And even if someone that's having some hearing difficulty, we suggest that they come in and they have the hearing checked. Because hearing difficulty is one of strangest things, because most people will deny that they have a hearing problem.
Oh, yeah.
Because
my father. Oh, well, you're mumbling.
Because how would you know when you miss something?
Yeah.
So, for example, many people come in and for 30 minutes to an hour, they hear everything that we say and they deny they have a hearing problem. But where they have the hearing problem is when background noise, if someone is further away, if they don't get a chance to read their lips, all those things make it difficult for them to hear clearly and understand clearly. Because the other thing we've been talking about is understanding. Most people can hear you talking or have audibility, but the problem remains they don't always understand what's being said.
And if you're in a room full of people, forget it.
Background noise.
That's very tight. You know, it was 2013. I had to have a mastoidectomy because, well, I'd had radiation years before, and what happened is, over the years, it can kind of destroy your inner ear, unfortunately. Mm-hmm. So he took out the mastoid. He said it was just crumbling. Okay. And I was pretty much warned, you're going to have a hearing issue. Well, I told him, leave the ossicles, because I had studied that that was a good thing to leave. I guess he did. And Dr. Shell, who was terrific over at UMass, I have a gadget. It's, I don't know what you call it. It's like a bone conductor. If I wear it, I forget it half the time because I can hear you fine. But it goes in this ear like a hearing aid, and there's like a little one here, but it conducts it somehow through my bone into the good ear.
Yes.
It's okay, but if I'm in a crowd, I don't know. I can hear you fine without it, but that's what they gave me. Or they gave me a choice. What do you call that thing that they implant in your head? What is that?
Cochlear implant.
Oh, I said, no, I don't need that. I was really kind of going over the top. You look like a Borg from Star Wars. Yeah, I don't want that thing in my head. Do you see that often, people who have mastoidectomies or anything like that?
I would say we saw more of that in the past. Mm. They tend to catch that earlier today, and they can treat it with antibiotics. But people with mastoidectomies, we saw them more, you know, 20 years ago than in the last 5 years.
Yeah, they could not. They were great at UMass. He tried, Dr. Shell tried and tried to try to cure it.
Right.
You know, but he kept coming back. Mm. He says, I don't trust that ear. And he was sharp. He came out and told Paul after the surgery, it was just crumbling. Mm. So I accept it. I hear noises in there, like a buzzing and stuff. But
I think the key message is, if you're having trouble hearing in background noise, if you're having trouble hearing if someone's a little bit further away, if you're having trouble hearing if someone's behind you or to one side where you don't get to see their lips moving, then it's time to have your hearing checked.
Yeah.
Because I can tell you most of the time people are in denial that they're having a problem. Because in quiet one-on-one situations, they'll say, I hear you just fine. Why do I need some assistance? Yeah. But that's not the situation where you need it the most. It's when the challenging situations arise and then they don't have the...
I know it. Even though I can hear fine here, I understand that part where you can't always get it. I'm like, in a crowded room. Alex, tell us about when the person comes and makes an appointment at ProHearing Health in Westboro. What happens when they come in that door? I'm a little bit nervous. What do you do?
Well, yeah, we greet them and we welcome them to our office. But we have them fill out a little questionnaire, and it gives us a little bit of better understanding of what's bringing them to our office. And what issues that they're dealing with. And we invite them in, and we always start with a case study. I want to find out more about what's going on and why they're here. Usually we'll take a look inside their ears. We have a great little camera, and it allows us to look inside our patient's ears, and we look for wax, and we make sure the eardrum looks healthy. And then after that, we will usually do a hearing test, if that's why they're here. And then after going through the hearing test, we do a very extensive hearing test. Because like my dad was saying, it's really important to understand that hearing, there's more than just hearing. It's hearing, but then also understanding.
Yes, I can hear what the person said, but I don't know what they said.
Exactly. Yeah. So we test in a couple of different ways. One way is hearing the beeping tones.
Yeah.
So that's testing the hearing, and then we also test word understanding so that we read words to you and have you repeat the words back to us. Right. And that gives us an understanding of how well you understand or are able to discriminate words from each other.
Yeah.
Some people, they test fine with that they test excellent, 100%. Yeah. Other people, we read them words, and they can only respond or repeat half of them back to us.
Yeah.
And so that's a much more challenging hearing loss to deal with.
Is that tough to get it through to them? Like, this really just happened. You didn't get it right. Some people like, oh no, maybe the husband or the wife brought them in. I think you were talking about that they're on WCRN, 8:30 on the AM dial. Yeah. Before we forget, Wednesdays at what time?
One
to two. And then Sundays?
One to two.
Tune them in. They're great. When I finally heard them again the other day, I'm like, yes, finally. But so what you, I think you were mentioning sometimes that one of the spouses will come in and not be too happy about being there, right? But their spouse or someone says, you really need to go. And they're right. How do you handle that? It's a matter of pride, but I think with a lot of our older citizens, you know, they're like, I'm not going.
Well, I think we handle that in a dignified manner. And we explain to them that, hey, if you have a hearing problem, you're sort of the last person to know.
Yeah.
But your wife is with you all the time, and she knows when you're not hearing. And in truth, you've been using her as a walking, talking, hearing aid for all these years.
Yeah.
And she's getting tired of being the walking, talking, hearing aid. And when we read those words to her, there's a loudspeaker in the room, so the wife can actually hear the word that we're saying and hear their response. So oftentimes, the word is just misunderstood. So the word might be me, M-E, and they hear me, K-N-E-E. So it's not like they miss the word, but they just don't pick up all the little specific nuances of the words, which is why it's really important to have a good quality hearing test to understand what is it that you hear and understand, and what is it that you hear and don't understand. But in addition, in the last, ever since Alex has joined my practice, we've started a new testing protocol. It's called Speech and Noise. Oftentimes in the past, people would come in and say, well, you tested me in a quiet sound booth. I don't have any trouble in quiet. It's only when I'm in noise. Yeah. And so by introducing the speech and noise test, it really helps us evaluate how well you can hear when there's background noise in the room.
Is that like fuzzy sound shh that comes through on the test to make sure you can still hear? Raise your hand if you still hear.
It's like, no, it's actually... We read you five sentences. The first sentence is when there's no background noise. And each subsequent sentence, we add 5 decibels of background noise. And so by the end, it determines the signal-to-noise ratio. How loud is the signal and how loud is the noise? Yeah. And then we calculate every single word that you get correct. So the sentence might be, she walked down the street yesterday. And then we track every word. And some people don't. I heard you say, she walked, but I didn't hear the last. Mm. And each time we increase the noise, even normal hearing people will start having fewer and fewer of those words correct. And that's how we gauge what your ability to understand in noise is. It's really a simple test, but it tells us so much about your ability to process sound in background noise.
Alex, how long does this test take?
Our test can be about 45 minutes to an hour, depending on how challenging the person's hearing loss is. Yeah. So the test that you're referring to was because you have more hearing on one ear compared to the other ear.
Oh, yeah.
So that's why they were playing that shh sound.
Yeah.
Those tests take a little bit longer because there's more protocols that we need to go through.
Yeah, definitely. But now, how can people reach you?
Yeah, so people can reach us by phone. Our number is 508-366-8686. Or you can visit our website, which is prohearinghealth.com.
And your address?
And we're at 33 Lyman Street in Westboro.
And you do need to call and make an appointment.
Yeah, well, we prefer that. Yeah. We do welcome walk-ins. But if you call us beforehand, it allows us to get ready for you.
What are your hours and days?
Typically, we start in the morning around 10 o'clock, and then... we'll usually, our last appointment's usually 4:30, but we'll take later appointments if necessary. So you just give us a call and say, hey, I can't get there until like 5:30, 6. Then I'll
You'll
say,
wait.
Okay, yeah, we'll be here.
We're talking with Peter Lee and his son Alex, and they are both professional hearing healthcare associates at their company, Pro Hearing Health, over in Westboro. I have a question that I wonder, if a person lets this hearing thing go and go, and it doesn't... is it progressive? It is.
It is progressive. Yeah. It is really progressive. In fact, the thing that progresses is your hearing levels decline, so you don't hear as much. But more importantly, your ability to understand words and speech declines as well. So that a person might come in and they're hearing, you know, 95-96% of the words. We had a gentleman, you know, 5 years later, he had dropped down to like 60% of the words understanding. Again, it's not they didn't hear the words, but they have trouble picking out those words because in the English language, a lot of words sound similar.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't understand that word, you actually misunderstand the contents of the conversation. And that's really, really challenging to correct.
Yeah, you can think you're hearing something and you come back, they didn't say they saw a bee. Oh, you went out to tea? Like, no, that's not what I did.
Yeah.
Can they buy their hearing aids at your place too?
Yep.
We dispense hearing aids, yes.
You can do that too. And if somebody has a problem, I know our camera technician, Paul, he was just talking about maybe bringing his over there and seeing Peter and Alex because it's driving him nuts. he's just not hearing as correctly as he should be.
And the thing about hearing loss is that the longer you wait to correct it or treat your hearing, the harder it becomes to treat your hearing. Because the worse your hearing loss gets, the harder it is to restore it.
So in other words, the longer you wait, you were lucky. How old were you when you got yours treated?
In the first grade.
So 6 years old.
Yeah.
How did the teachers, we've talked about this, did the teachers point this out or did your dad know?
Teachers didn't point it out, but they noticed that I was very attentive in class. They noticed that whenever they spoke, my eyes would be on them.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, other students could have been, you know, looking around but still hearing the teacher. Whereas for people with hearing problems or hearing loss, they have to be focused in order to hear and understand. It's not, for me, I can't just, you know, just sit somewhere and absorb and understand sounds. I have to give my attention to you.
Focus, yeah.
And focus and listen. And that's why it's so hard for some people that have hearing problems to recognize it, because they'll say, hey, if you want me to hear you, you need to talk to me.
Yeah.
And then that's when they can focus and hear. Yeah. But for people with normal hearing, they don't need to do that. Yeah. They can just, you know, move from one conversation to another, and it's very simple. They never even think about having to attend and focus to listen.
Yeah. I know my grandfather used to drive us bananas. He had his hearing aid, and I'd go up and say, hey, Grandpa, and I'd start talking to him. He'd go, oh, wait a minute, turning it up. He would turn it down so he couldn't hear the sounds in the kitchen. It was very frustrating. Is that still that today? Can you still turn it up, your volume and all?
You can still adjust the volume, but today's technology is like light years ahead of what
yeah,
he was
well, it was off. He didn't want to hear the dishes clanking and rattling. Is that typical of some hearing aids? You can hear it too much in the background?
Well, I've been involved for a long time, so I can state that in the old days, what we had were linear amplifiers. What that means, it makes a soft sound, medium sound, loud sound. It amplifies it the same all the time.
Yeah.
And so when you're in a noisy environment, you would tend to turn the volume down.
Yeah.
Today we have digital hearing aids, almost all exclusively digital hearing aids. And the digital hearing aid actually listens for the level of sound, and it does two things. When it hears a soft sound, that's when the hearing aid works the hardest. When it hears a loud sound, that's the time it works the least. So it manages the noise better for you today than it did in the past.
Yeah,
and that's the true difference of the new modern technology compared to the older hearing aids from even 5, 10, 15 years ago.
You could see, I mean, back then, when I was a little girl, I was growing up and I'd see him. You know, I mean, it was no doubt he was wearing one. Nowadays, we can't even tell half the time. The producer of the show, Glenn, I had no idea he had a hearing aid on for years. He told me he did. But his back when Grandpa was having him, they were, you knew. You could see that flesh-colored gizmo in the back. And he'd be, wait a minute, he'd be tuning it up. It's like he could tune you out at will. Very frustrating to the family, very, very much. What do you think the age group is mostly that you... Everybody? Anybody? The kids, too?
Anyone can have a hearing loss. Yeah. And I think that scares... Or not a lot of people realize that. They'll think, oh, I must be getting old. That's why I have a hearing loss.
Yeah.
But we see people of all ages.
Yeah.
And hearing loss is not normal as you get older in age, but it becomes more common.
Yeah.
So more people are more likely to have hearing loss.
Why is it more common? What happens structurally, chemically? What happens?
Basically,
there are certain processes that when we grow, our ears don't work as well as they did 5, 10, 15 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
I use the example, we can't climb stairs the way we did 5, 10, 15 years ago. We don't have the energy. Same thing with your ears. As it's been exposed to more and more sound and louder sounds, and the higher frequencies, you just drop. I mean, it's almost an aging process. But there are other things that cause it, too. You know, people are born like this genetically. Exposure to loud noises.
Yeah.
Even someone that's been in the armed services, firing of weapons, running motorcycles, construction jobs, any type of noise that comes in... will slowly destroy those hair cells in your
rock
ears.
Rock bands.
So, in fact, I would say for the last 100 years, most of the hearing difficulty, other than the people who were born like this, is, I call it human-induced, you know, subways, firing of weapons, explosions. So, 200 years ago, you didn't have these types of explosions.
Mm-hmm.
So almost everything is human-induced.
I remember my parents, well, I'd go in my room. They didn't want to hear my rock and roll. So I would have my headset on, right? And I'd have it on loud enough. And I don't know if that can cause it, I suppose.
If it's loud enough and you listen to it long enough, it can cause damage.
It can do it. Mm-hmm. Oh, so what do you think caused yours, Alex? What happened?
It's unexplained, so nobody really knows.
And you weren't upset about it? You just got your hearing aids and you were fine, right? Or did you feel different than
well,
the other kids?
Naturally, I felt different from everyone else, and I was fortunate to have a good support group. Yeah. But I think what I went through is similar to what a lot of other people that have hearing loss go through, is you don't realize it. Everyone else around you is telling you, hey, you have a hearing problem.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I don't have a hearing problem. I can still hear you.
Yeah.
But I had nothing to compare it with.
Yeah.
You know, I only know how well I hear at this present moment. I don't know how well I heard, you know, when I was 2 years old, for example.
Yeah.
So that's why it's hard to wrap your mind around it. But if people are telling you, hey, you need to get your hearing checked, they're saying that for your benefit. They're not saying that to nag you.
No.
Just getting your hearing checked is really important, and it should be done more often.
Yeah, I know my father's old line was, well, you're mumbling, or you need to speak louder. You know, really, after a while, it gets kind of old. Can they can buy their hearing aids there. How long does it take once you order them? Do you get them?
Usually it takes, within a couple of weeks, we can get the hearing aids.
That's good.
And then we go through our fitting process.
Yeah.
Our fitting process is where we take the patient and we walk step by step, going through the hearing aids, what to expect. And most importantly, we have what we call the 5 C's of better hearing. So first is comfort.
Mm-hmm.
So we make sure that the hearing aids are comfortable in your ears. Second is clarity. We make sure that you're hearing well with them and you like the way you hear.
Yeah.
Third is cosmetics. You like the way they look.
Yeah.
Fourth is convenience. We want them to be easy to use, whether you're changing batteries or just turning them off, easy to use. And then fifth is connectivity.
Yeah.
It's being able to connect with your cell phone, being able to connect with the TV, all the devices that we have. We want our hearing aids to connect to them so that you have an easier time listening and understanding.
So a person can bring in their hearing aids, you know, and they say, look, these aren't working. They didn't get them at your place. They're not working. I've had them for a couple of years. And you can kind of get down to what the problem just might be, right, and help them out with
yes.
that type of thing.
Yes, that happens often.
Yeah.
We get a lot of referrals from people. I didn't get them from you, but, you know, my friend got them from you, and she said I should come in with the hearing aids. And, hearing aids is a very high-tech instrument, and if they're not cleaned and checked every 6 months or so, they can fall into problems because inside your ear, there's perspiration, wax, dirt, dust, and debris that build up, and it clogs the sound passages.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
So,
they've had to use a suction thing with my ears.
Yeah, we have a vacuum that we work with.
Remember they used to do the water thing?
Mm-hmm.
I won't let them do it because it made me like that.
Dizzy.
And it's not good. It shoves it back inside, doesn't it? What is, I like that suction to use it. I like that. That's good.
You can use water safely, and it
really?
Can remove wax, yeah. But I think sometimes when people, for example, I've seen a couple of patients, they came in with hearing aids that they got online.
Uh-oh.
And they weren't fitted properly for them.
Yeah.
They didn't know how to use them properly. And so, I had to do a whole orientation for them because they weren't given the tools to use the hearing aids that they received well. They didn't work for them because they weren't fitted for them.
Yeah, the ones that I've got were professionally done, but you know what? Part of the reason I don't use them, I don't think about it, but part of the reason is that I'm not sure, what do I do with this part, and who that goes where, and why does it have to go on this ear? This ear's fine, and blah, 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 blah. It just seems such a complicated thing when it really isn't. But
Hearing loss is complicated,
yeah.
And treating it is very complicated. It's not as easy as glasses.
Yeah.
Glasses are very easy compared to treating hearing loss.
Really? Do you think that people are becoming more and more aware of it? You've got your radio show on WCRN Wednesdays at 1 o'clock, Sundays at what time?
1 o'clock.
At 1 o'clock. WCRN 8:30 on the AM dial. It's great to hear them. It's great to see, even greater to see them in person. But I'm driving along like, oh yeah, I know those two. I know them very well. Do you think that it's becoming more common that people are stepping up to the plate and saying, yeah, I need help? What do you think?
I think they are. Yeah. A lot of people have been touting that the technology is getting better, and that's without a doubt. Technology is getting better, but even more importantly, as professionals, we're getting better at our craft and helping fit people appropriately so that they like what they're wearing. They like the way they feel, they sound, everything about them.
Well, what's the thing that Bluetooth people wear? You know, it's so common now to have something in your ear that I don't really think about. Well, yeah, maybe he's in tune with his studio or whatever. You know, I don't even think. Except then I look a little closer and I think, oh yeah, that's one of those newfangled ones, like the little one I got. And I don't even use that. It conducts through the bone. That's what they told me. This little gadget.
Yours does.
Mine does.
Ear conduction.
No, it's a radio.
It's a radio, right?
The Bluetooth.
No, the little thing I have because of mastoidectomy, right? It's like a little radio conductor that goes to the good ear. I don't even wear it. But anyway, that's how they explained to me how it was going to work. It was either that or do nothing or have that doggone cochlear implant thing. I'm like, I don't think so.
I want to stop here for a second, Jan. You can look at this as half empty or half full, the glass. And being in the industry as long as I've been, I really feel like we haven't done a good job. The industry haven't done a good job in making people aware of what hearing loss is all about. So, for example, we know to go to our dentist every 6 months to have our teeth checked. We know to go get our blood pressure checked regularly for our heart disease. But we know that people who are obese is highly linked with heart problems, cardiac problems. But too many people walk around with a hearing problem thinking, oh, it's just a hearing problem. What's the big deal? Mm. And we haven't done a good job in explaining to the general public that if you don't treat your hearing loss, bad things happen to you. They continue to happen to you. In fact, they've even linked early to mild dementia with untreated hearing difficulties.
Yes, that makes an awful lot of sense.
And they quantify that you travel down this path to early and mild dementia 30, 40, 50% faster than a person with normal hearing.
Well,
it's because you're depriving your brain of important signals. And as those signals don't get in, it just slowly, slowly deteriorates. And before you know it, they begin to exhibit short-term memory loss.
Yeah.
They exhibit all kinds of things that are closely aligned with dementia. And in 2011, they came up with this landmark study. And we, as an industry, the medical community, we've done a poor, poor job in informing people of the risks. And thank you for giving us the opportunity to inform people of the risks. So if there's one message I can leave you with, is just get your hearing checked. Mm-hmm. It's painless, and you know by the time you finish whether you have a problem or you don't have a problem. You can still choose not to treat it. That's your prerogative.
Sure.
But at least you know what you're facing. And too many people in our society are putting the wool over their eyes. They don't want to see. And I tell you that because there's only about 30% of the people in the United States who have hearing difficulties that actually take treatment or action of any type. And that means there's a 70% of the population have not moved forward to do something to treat the hearing. And that's really sad,
sad. Don't think it's just an age thing either, because young Alex here, he was just a kid. When they figured it out, I mean, it isn't just if you hit, oh my God, 50, 60, 70, 80. It's ageless. It can happen, you know. Before we close again, how can they reach you?
You can reach us at 508-366-8686, or you can visit our website at prohearinghealth.com. That's P-R-O, hearing, H-E-A-R-I-N-G, health, H-E-A-L-T-H.com. And give
right
us a call.
Beautiful sign they bring with them. Paul, you focused on it before, but we've got it right here. And can't get any better. They brought me and Paul a great cup with some pens. I can always use pens. This is great. I can use all a coffee cup. You got to go. And they treat you like family. Okay. Nothing to be afraid of at all. They're friendly as can be. I highly recommend it. Thanks for being on, guys.
Thank you.
They'll be back. They will be back. Listen
Thank
to them
you for
on
having
WCU.
Us, Jim. We really appreciate the opportunity.
You're welcome.
to send the message out if we can.
We'll see you next time and be my guest.
Riding on a shooting star.